Small businesses can learn how to connect with resources to build their reach and reach their goals. Leah Bowling is the city's Division Director of Procurement. Luis Matos is manager, and Israel Sanchez is GoTopeka's Director of Equity and Business Development. They are all here to tell us about the Supplier Diversity Workshop. And we did hear a little bit from Israel about this earlier this week, but it's such a broad topic. And since you deal with procurement, how much business does the city do with entities all over?
We do a lot of different types of business with all different sorts of contractors and professional service providers. And so we try to engage with all different varieties around the city and in the area to help support city operations.
What sorts of things would you be looking for people to supply?
So anything from contractors who would do sidewalks or curbs and gutters to professional service providers, photographers, media of certain sorts.
Pens and paper?
Yes. Office supplies.
The basic things.
Office supplies even.
When you manage the program, Luis, what have you found small businesses are able sometimes to bring to the table that maybe some of those large national chains can't?
They understand our community. They know our needs. They want to scale and grow their businesses and stay within Topeka limits. They don't want to have to drive hours away to Wichita or, you know, even a few miles down the road to Lawrence to do work. They want to be here and support our community.
But the flip side of that, I think sometimes small businesses think, oh, you're a big government entity, so therefore I'm too small to work with you. That's not true.
That is not the case. We have many opportunities. You know, there's a lot of smaller projects that are constantly ongoing. There's various departments within the city government entity that, you know, do anything from very small projects where, you know, you could maybe be on the site for a few days or a week. And then, yes, there's obviously large projects ongoing that, you know, may be better served by a larger construction company or supplier.
When you bring small businesses to the table, Israel, how does that help with really promoting that diversity and equity message, bringing people of all different backgrounds and groups to the table to do business with an organization like the city?
I think it's important not only to help the economy for those families, of course, and also our city, but I think it also, you get different perspectives, you get different, histories and different resources that they have as well, right? So like it's important to diversify not only in the business, but also the resources they have. And to have something like this event is really important because that way they can learn about the city of Topeka, all they do. Because a lot of times small businesses don't know what they do. How can they get a permit or how can they get on their list to get business done? So this is just really important for everybody to be there.
So the workshop, yes, what is it that people can expect? Because it's an all-day event. It's 10 o'clock to 2 o'clock on November 13th. So what is going to happen? What can people learn?
So the workshop is really to help bring small businesses, striving entrepreneurs into the area to show them what resources exist, being with the partners that GoTopeka offers, and things like that. Also anchor institutions within the community, so big organizations that can help support and provide additional resources and education to entrepreneurs on how to do business with government and larger organizations like that. So for example, the City of Topeka, Shawnee County, 501, will have a segment on doing business with government agencies and how we can help support those entrepreneurs.
And it's free, right? Free information?
It is.
Absolutely. It's all free. There's food involved as well. and yeah, it's a free event. And, you know, we just want to be sure to put information out there. There's information that the community and businesses may not be aware of. And what we're trying to do is break down silos and provide that information to them and just know that the city's not the only one out there seeking work.
And then Israel, as we see there, this is followed up with a Friday lunch and learn, or November 15th, a lunch and learn that's at the GTP boardroom.
Correct, so these guys will be there also at GTP boardroom, and probably some of the same thing, maybe a more condensed version of it, but it'll be, you know, people can ask questions directly as well. So we're excited to have the city there as well.
And Go Topeka is where you can register for the luncheon, but it is free as well. They just want to make sure they have enough food. And then there's a procurement website. I'll get that link on WIBW.com as well. So if you can't make either of those events, you can at least go to that website and find some of the information there. Leah, Lewis, Israel, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you
for
having
us. A good couple of events next week. We'll spend a lot of time together. We're going to get a look at whether these clouds mean rain as we head into the night and the new weekend next.